Good morning and welcome back to the Roy's channel. Thank you to all of those who have subscribed, and thank you so much for the overwhelming response that we got when we were at MBCI TV on the Virtuous Woman show. We are very glad that that content was good for you and it benefited you and you learned something new. Both parents and young people were talking to us on our social media platforms, and we say a big thank you to all of you. Now, as we remember that last week we were talking about how to remain mentally sober in the wake of negative and wrong social media influence, and we talked about the effects that social media has on you last week. Now, this week we are going to talk about how we can run away from the addiction and how we can make informed decisions when we are using social media. Before we get into it, remember, for those, all of those who haven't subscribed, subscribe to this channel so that you can get content every single time that we post, so that we can continue encouraging one another before we go back to school and meet you in your schools. So in case I'm looking down, I'm just looking at my notes to refer, and let's begin. So the first point, we were talking about how we can make informed choices and decisions when using social media. And we talked about how even the social media gurus and the creators of these platforms and devices, they don't use these platforms themselves, or some of the employees that were, this was their brainchild, they stopped using it completely, meaning that they have very serious psychological effects on you. And today we are going to have the tips on how to not become addicted and how we can make informed choices. The first one is find hands-on activities that you do and enjoy. This can be something like painting. Some people like to do pottery. Some people like to go hiking. Some people like to go picnicking. Bird watching is one of my personal favorite hobbies. And many other things. Some like gardening. Some can find DIY, do-it-yourself projects online, and you can try and do them yourself and see how it is that you are going to achieve these things. So find something that you can do with your hands that is going to keep you off the screens so that you can get your mind and your body active. Remember, our body was meant for movement, not for sitting down doing very little. So when you're looking at something on TV or on your screen, on your phone, you're doing very little movement. Actually, you're static. You don't move until that program ends. But if you're moving around doing something around, maybe gardening, remember your skin is elastic. It was created to move. Your body is full of joints that can move all around and everywhere, because you are meant for movement, not for stagnation. So do things that keep you active. It activates your mind. That's the reason why exercise is so good even for your mental health, because we were meant for movement. So do things with your hands that are going to help you to remain active, and this is a way that you can be able to stay away from your screen for longer. The second point is set aside time for the internet. Definitely, like last week we spoke about those young people who use the internet for more than 2 hours in a day usually are more prone to mental health issues and anxiety and depression and all of those things. So set aside time for everything. Put the to-do list, your to-do list down. Let the things that you do with your hands that we talked about in the previous point be in the list, and let social media be somewhere in the list, but don't spend too much time on it. Okay, less than 2 hours. But if you have to be online, then make sure you're gaining something. Remember, we talked about that your time is their currency, so we have to make sure we also gain something from the time we spend online. So make sure you're listening to things like motivational content, like what you're listening to right now, tips to better yourself. You can also do the DIY projects. You can get them online and do them yourself using your hands. And all those things can help you to set aside time where you use social media just for fun, and make sure that you have the time when you're gaining something from the internet, and then the other things that you do aside from leisure. Yes. The third point is avoid controversial pages that will potentially lead you to sin. So we know that one of the most well-known facts about the internet is that there's a lot of dirty content on the internet, but it wasn't meant for that. So these people took advantage of it. But you also can decide, you have the power to decide what you see online. So what I advise is that when you see a controversial page, unfollow it and report it. That is the only way that Facebook and all the other platforms will know that this page has very bad content. And secondly, if it is your friends, then don't feel free to unfollow people. I mean, the Facebook doesn't tell them that you have unfollowed them. They do not. So unfollow them. And so that you don't keep seeing on your newsfeed things that always make you feel like it's leading you astray. Like David said, I will set nothing wicked before my eyes. I hate the work of those who fall away. It shall not cling to me. Why is he connecting what he sees with something bad clinging to him? It is because what you see has the ability to affect you and affect how you act. So be careful what you see online and follow pages and people who have content that makes you uncomfortable, and feel free to do it. These platforms, don't tell them that you have unfollowed them. Even Job, he said, I have made a covenant with my eyes. Why then should I look upon a young woman? What does that mean? That he knows just looking upon a young woman would make him desire her and would lead to sin. Look at what happened to David and Bathsheba. So be careful what you see. It matters. Be careful what you allow into the windows of your soul, which are your eyes. The final point in this one is avoid posting too much too often. You will realize, and this is true also for me, anytime I'm posting something, I tend to get tempted to keep checking who has liked the photo, which comments are coming in. So I keep checking my online platforms more and more every time I post something. So what do I say? Live in the moment, forget about posting too much. And if you have to post, then don't post too often so that it doesn't steal your time. This is what happens. Anytime you get a notification, there's a hormone in your brain that is released called dopamine hormone. Now, this dopamine hormone is the feel-good hormone. When you're happy, when you're excited, this is the hormone that is released. Now, that is when you get a new like or a notification. When you stay without looking at your phone for long and you're wondering who else has liked your photo, who else has commented, there's also another hormone that is released. And this hormone is called cortisol hormone. And this is the stress hormone. So you feel anxious, you feel agitated, you want to check your phone. That is a stress hormone being released, making you want to check your phone. And this is why the phones are so addictive, because this is exactly what drugs do to your brain. So it activates 70% of dopamine in your brain, slightly less than what cocaine activates in your brain. So this is just as addictive as cocaine. And we say, no, don't give children cocaine. Cocaine is illegal. But we have social media and we are using it much more than even cocaine users use it. So be careful, okay? Don't post too often so that you're not tempted to always be online checking for notifications and you don't stress yourself. Got it? Okay. So the final thing we're going to talk about in this topic is running away from social media addiction. And here, I would like to give it in a perspective of what benefits do you get when you are not addicted to social media? What benefits are there for you? Because when we know the benefits, then we are motivated to do what? To stay away from social media addiction. And on this, I have 6 points. And the first one is, it breaks the comparison cycle, which has an impact on your self-esteem. You remember when we talked about last week the compare and despair attitude, that when you see things, especially on Instagram, you think everybody's life is so explosive and ceremonial, but yours is boring. So that compare and despair attitude is lessened when you're not online too often and too long. Remember about the 2 hours a day. Make sure you're using less than that so that it doesn't affect your self-esteem and you don't think that your life is boring. Everybody's life is boring, but online, we like to look good, right? Exactly. So that's the first thing. The second thing, you'll stop feeling so competitive with others and with yourself. competitiveness is what causes anxiety. So when you see all these people are going for holidays and, you know, buying new things, someone bought a new phone or a new camera, you feel like, what have I bought? What new thing have I bought? So you feel like you want to compete with this person. So when you're not online too often, so many things will happen and they won't affect you because you'll be very keen building your own life and not comparing yourself to what another person did and what you can do to outdo that person. You get it? So it helps you to live your own life and better your own reality. Another benefit of not being social media addicted is you let go of the past by not seeing your ex-friends and your past life. It leads you to healing. You know, when you are hurt by something or when something happens, the best way to heal is to stay away from that something or someone. So if you're always online and you're following the same people and these people are from your past and maybe they hurt you in one way or the other, the more you see them, the more that wound will not heal. It will take so much longer. So what do we recommend? Stay away from social media. Don't see those people or altogether unfollow them so that you can build a new life, okay, with the new people that are there in your life. All right, the fourth point is, don't mind the people who are making noise around here, the fourth point is you live in the moment, and at the end of life, all you have are the memories you created. So create memories. I was talking to a very old man in his late 90s, actually, and he's a man in his right mind. God has really blessed him. So when I was having a conversation with him, I was telling him what I am doing. And all he could say is that, oh, yes, that's very good. Even me, when we were young, we used to do this and this and this. And that taught me something. When you get to the older ages where you cannot do much, you cannot go far, you cannot walk so long, you know, you can't do what you used to do when you were young, the only thing you're left with are the memories you created when you were young. So if you did the wrong things when you were young, those are the memories you will have, and you will have an older life full of regret. But if you lived a good life from when you were young, when you are older, the memories you have are memories of good things, of how you helped others, of how you changed a life here and there. And that is what you will have. So you'll have a very happy older life, and you will definitely live longer. And so what I recommend is live in the moment, make good memories, do something good for someone else. Make sure you're taking yourself out and having new experiences so that you can have better memories when you are older. You won't remember all the things that are stressing you right now. Actually, 1 year from now, what you're stressing about so much won't even be important. So don't stress so much about it. Don't compete with anyone. Build your own life and make your own memories. Live in the moment. The second last point is you gain a lot of free time, which you can use to develop your overall being, performance, and future. So when you free up the time you used to use on social media, if you used to use 4 hours on social media, now when you reduce it to just 1.5 hours, for example, you have a whole 2.5 hours to use on something that will actually grow you. You can read books, you can have community service, you can go and volunteer at a children's home, you can go picnicking or hiking with your friends, you can connect with real people, yani physical connection. I know it's the time of this pandemic and you can't really gather many people, but still you can meet that one friend and do the social distancing and all the sanitizing and everything, but you'll have that in-person connection with your friend, which matters a lot more than just looking at random people online, which has an impact on your self-esteem. So go out there and meet new people, make new friends, meet your friends, follow the guidelines that we have been given for social distancing, but do something new that will create the memories and give you a better life and boost your self-esteem in the end. Okay.